EWSB. What is that? Electro weak symmetry breaking. Hello guys, this is Ritik Awasthi presenting this video to you. We all know that our universe is operated upon by four fundamental forces of nature, namely gravity, strong interaction, weak interaction, and electromagnetic interaction. Also, these four forces are manifestation of a single unified force that operated upon the universe in distant past. As the universe evolved with time, the force suffered bifurcation, and today we have four different forces. If we have a look on electromagnetic interaction and weak interaction by considering their Feynman diagram, we find that both these forces are very much similar to each other, only difference in their mediating particles. Now question develops in mind that why electroweak force broke down into electromagnetic and weak interactions when they were so similar in nature. Let's see. This is the standard model of particle physics. It contains all the fundamental particles of nature. They are total 17 in number. These six purple particles are quarks. These six green particles are leptons. Now these remaining five particles are bosons. The four orange ones are gauge bosons, which mediate fundamental forces of nature. And the yellow one is scalar boson, Higgs boson, which is quanta of the Higgs field. This story goes back to the time of the electroweak epoch, when the temperature of the universe was extremely high and the universe was massless. As the universe expanded, the temperature of the universe decreased to a critical point at which the Higgs field acquired tachyonic nature. Now, what does that mean? In simple words, on acquiring tachyonic nature, the Higgs field became omnipresent, since it acquires a non-zero vacuum expectation value. That is, the field always has some value in vacuum. Now back to the story. On acquiring a non-zero vacuum expectation value, the Higgs field began to behave as a normal field. And the Higgs field began its interaction with the particles that were present in the universe, except photons and gluons, and gave mass to the particle interacted with it. It is the interaction of W and Z boson with the Higgs field that broke the symmetrical nature between W and Z boson and photons. Thus, we perceive both forces as two different forces. But how Higgs field generates mass? And why does Higgs field is omnipresent and has non-zero vacuum expectation value? Back in 1960s, three independent group of scientists almost simultaneously proposed a mechanism to generate mass without breaking gauge symmetry. The mechanism demands a scalar bosonic field interaction with which generates the mass of the interacting particle. The field is famously known as the Higgs field. The mechanism is generally called Higgs mechanism or ABEGHHKTH mechanism, which stands for Anderson, Braut, Englert, Guralnik, Hagen, Higgs, Kibble, Anti-Hooft mechanism. Now coming back to the question that how Higgs field generates mass. As Higgs field permeates throughout the universe, any particle passing through the field that can interact with the field interacts with it all the time. And this interaction produces a dragging effect. And this very effect is perceived as mass. To understand this, consider a case in which a triangle and a square are pulled through a still water body. Now the one that is narrower can be pulled much easily than the broader one. Thus, the triangle easily gets through the water body as compared to the square. This is so because in the direction of its motion, the triangle does not have to be so interactive with the water as it easily displaces the water to proceed further. Whereas in the case of square, in the direction of its motion, it has to struggle badly with water. The struggle is analogous to the interaction, and the drag due to the water is similar to the drag of the Higgs field, that is mass. Thus, the more will be the struggle with water, the more will be drag due to the water. In the same way, the more will be interaction with the Higgs field, the more will be the mass of the interacting particle. The interaction of massless particles like photons and gluons with the Higgs field are analogous to the interaction of one-dimensional object with water while getting through it. Such an object will feel no drag, analogous to masslessness. But what accounts for the omnipresence of the Higgs field? The answer is its Mexican hat shaped potential versus field graph and its tachyonic nature, which allow it to lower its energy by spontaneously producing particle through a process called tachyonic condensation. If we refer to the graph, then we can see that the minimum potential energy of the graph is at a non-zero value of the field. Now suppose that if due to some reasons this tachyonic field starts fading away from existence, so the value of field begins to proceed towards zero. As the field strength decreases, the field needs more energy since its potential energy is increasing. But everything in this universe needs stability, and so does our Higgs field. So it lowers its energy by spontaneously producing particles through tachyonic condensation. Due to this, the field strength increases and potential decreases until the field reacquires its original configuration with its potential to be lowest. Since this minimum potential is attained at some value which is not equal to zero, thus we say that the Higgs field has non-zero expectation value in vacuum. We know that weak interaction and electromagnetic interaction were symmetrical forces earlier, but now they are not. We know that what happened, when happened, why happened, and how it happened. But what about the asymmetries and the difference between the two forces? Due to the spontaneous symmetry breaking, W and Z boson became massive, while photons remained massless. Due to this, the coupling constant of weak interaction is about 10 raised power minus 7 to 10 raised power minus 6, whereas that of electromagnetic interaction is 10 raised power minus 2. Range of weak interaction is about 10 raised power minus 17 to the 10 raised power minus 16 meter, whereas range of electromagnetic interaction is infinite. Weak interaction do not involve binding energy. Electromagnetic interaction involves binding energy. Weak interaction can change the flavor of the quarks. Electromagnetism cannot change the flavor of the quarks. At last, I would like to say that nature has designed everything perfectly. Everything is compatible with each other. Everything has a reason. Nature is far more imaginative than us and always amazes us with new surprises.